Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I have the honor to sponsor today two house bills which are aimed towards the improvement of two government hospitals. These house bills, House Bill number 6036 and House Bill 6144, were discussed and approved during the Committee on Health hearing last week. First is the increase in bed capacity of Cagayan Valley Medical Center, or CVMC. CVMC is a level 3 DOH hospital in Tuguegarao City, Cagayan, that caters to patients from Region 2 and nearby provinces of Cordillera Administrative Region such as Apayao, Kalinga, Ipugao. In 2018, CVMC recorded 6,155 hospital admissions. From 2018 to 2019, it has an average bed occupancy rate average of 158%, which is tremendously above the national standard of 85%. Thus, the bill seeks to increase the bed capacity of CVMC from 500 to 1,000 beds. We also aim to increase the bed capacity of Las Piñas General Hospital and Satellite Trauma Center, or the LPGH-STC. Currently, the LPGH is a 200-bed DOH hospital serving the cities of Las Piñas, Muntinlupa, Parañaque, Pasay, Bacoor, and Imus in Cavite. Currently, the LPGH is a 200-bed DOH hospital serving the cities of Las Piñas, Muntinlupa, Parañaque, Pasay, Bacoor, and Imus in Cavite. Its bed occupancy rate from 2018 to 19 averaged at 110.53%, which is exceedingly above the national standard of 85%. Thus, the need to upgrade from 200 beds to 500 beds. As we face the COVID-19 pandemic, it is crucial to improve our government health facilities. Overcrowding in public hospitals has been one of the weaknesses of our health system. In 2018, almost 65%, or 284 out of 437 public hospitals were overcrowded. This includes 51 or 73% of our hospitals. The DOH has also expressed its support to the proposed measures to more effectively manage our increasing number of patients. It is for these reasons that I am seeking this chamber support for the immediate passage of these measures. I also want to thank Senator Cynthia Villar and Senator Aimee Marcos for filing related Senate bills which were taken into consideration in our committee reports. Thank you, Mr. President.